Thanks for joining me here in the long dark. If you're not familiar with the long dark, it's a first-person open-world survival game based in the frozen mountains in Canada. Currently it's in alpha, as you can see up here. Story mode is not included yet, but sandbox is. And it's been commonly requested to play this game. So here we are. We're going to play as probably a Voyager, if that's how you say that. Looks a little bit different from Voyage, so basically this mode. We are an explorer, in equal parts hunter and hunted. The world will not give you anything freely, but you'll find that with time, you can master it. So it's kind of like the game's medium level. In this one, Pilgrim, animals don't attack you. But let's go for the full experience. And we'll start. Mystery Lake. And we'll just start as a boy. A mysterious geomagnetic storm has brought your plane crashing down into the northern Canadian wilderness. How long can you survive? Extinction is the rule, survival is the exception. Carl Sagan. Alright, so I've played this a little bit, and turns out I'm not great at these survival games. And we'll give it a crack. So immediately we're plopped into this sort of cave area. We've got a hunting knife, that's a good start. Not sure what a crow feather will do, but we'll take it. And we found a grape soda on the corpse. That'll come in handy when we get thirsty later. The hardest thing I found to manage was my thirst. I kept running out of water. Dave's quiet clearing. Alright. Now, I've got a map up next to me. See if I can find Dave's quiet clearing. I'll keep walking while I go. Alright, I can't find it on the map. So we're going to be on our own for a little bit till I can find a better landmark. I don't tend to play these open world survival games too much because, as I said, I'm terrible, but The Long Dark, I really enjoy it. I've seen it done for other ASMR videos and I enjoyed it. Alright, we're currently at negative 15 degrees Celsius, so we have to get inside pretty quick. Trying to take some cover from the wind here a bit, but it's not really working. I think we'll go uphill. I love the wind rushing past, whistling in the distance. Ooh, a hunting rifle, that's pretty cool. So we'll equip that and search the rest of this corpse. Matches, okay, that's pretty helpful. I'm not sure if we have any rounds, so we better fire. to come into a fight with a wolf and have no rounds. But we really do need to get inside because we are currently freezing. Lake Trail. Alright. Ah, good. A cabin. That's what we needed. Story mode in this game should be pretty cool. Alright, we're getting really cold. I'm just gonna head straight inside. Septic, I'll take that. And the lantern. Orange soda. What we really need to do is start finding some stuff to light a fire with. Perfect, we've even got a stove here. Lantern fuel, definitely stock up on that. Now we take the newsprint roll and the reclaimed wood as fire starting materials. We'll check the first aid kit as well. We put a candy bar in the first aid kit.
That'll come in handy.
A sewing kit. Okay, so we can repair our clothes from that now. It's probably best to find some warmer clothes anyway though. Coffee takes the edge off fatigue and keeps you warm. Might come in handy. A whetstone for sharpening knives. Let's take a look at there we're going. So it feels like 1 degree in here, so we're a lot warmer. Got 4 degrees bonus for our clothing. Starting to get a little bit hungry. We're mostly cold, but we're warming up. We've got a bunch of antiseptic, a bandage, some water purification tablets. They're definitely handy. You can boil snow and then purify it, and you get a couple of liters of drinking water. All our default clothing. Some drinks. Alright, so I think I need to mix that. Tools. We can sharpen it, but I'm not really sure what the point is so far. And we have a bunch of firewood. And our journal, we haven't made a day yet. When I was playing this game to test it before filming an ASMR video, I found myself in the Hydro Dam where I was savaged pretty brutally by a large wolf, which I later discovered its name is Fluffy, I believe. I lived and I got some good loot from that place, and then I froze to death looking for my next camp. Nothing in this poor fellow. Yeah, I'll take some socks. Basically, what you want to do with this game is pretty much take everything I've found. I think objects degrade whether or not you've a bedroll, that'll be handy. Objects degrade whether or not you've stored it in a container or not, I think, now. Oh, that'll be warm. We might be able to repair that a bit more, too. Another stove. Beds, how many? 3 hours of daylight. What do you reckon? We risk outside for a bit. See if we can get some more supplies for the first night. Let's equip our warmer clothes, which turns out is just that. Can we repair this? Okay, I need cloth to repair it, so we might. Oh no, it makes more sense to wear the jacket now. We might find something better anyway. Right, so we've got about 3 hours of daylight left. So, if we remember which direction we came in, we can head back to this cabin, and we'll go explore some of these cabins down on the lake. Alright, so we're actually at Mystery Lake now. So now I know where we are on the map. You can see some deer. Some ammo or a bow. Look at the crevices in the lake. I wonder if they'll make an update where you can fall through the ice if you walk on weak ice or something. That'd be interesting. For all you veterans out there, you'll have to take it easy on me. I lose sight of the goal sometimes, and my lastest time for surviving, my longest time for surviving, is about 2 days in this game, I think. Not great. Another sewing kit. Hatchet, so now we can harvest some wood. Sprint. Ooh, a rifle round. Just one round. Alright, let's reload our rifle, I guess. Now we have to save it in case a wolf's coming. And we'll have to try and hit it in the head, I think. We could take out that antelope right now, I reckon, but be a waste of a round, especially if it doesn't die. Okay, it's really cold. So we're gonna head inside. I have to check this guy. Nothing on him. Bad luck.
I could use this.
Doesn't burn for long. That's fine. We can use it first. A hook. Hold on to that. Soda and scrap metal. Shut the door. We need some fire starter. Would be very handy right now. Oh, another rifle round. And a scarf. Jeez, this cupboard's loaded. Let's equip our scarf. Nice warm scarf. Alright, we're really cold. Everything else is alright. Oh, we do have an accelerant. Okay, well. Let's see how long of daylight we've got left. 2 hours.
Cold is making my head feel thick.
Alright, let's run for that cabin. Try and get out of the cold fast. There's a lot of good cabins around here to check out, so that's good. We'll start with the furthest one. Hope I don't accidentally fire my rifle instead of searching something. Oh, sardines. And peaches. I love peaches. Bunch of wooden objects that we can break down if we need to. Container to search. Candy bar. Oh, backpack. Should have some good stuff. Should we better take on at least one wolf now. Alright, let's have a look. 2 degrees Celsius. We're quite cold. We could get into bed and rest for an hour. Let's rest for an hour. We'll have 1 hour left of daylight. We'll warm up a bit. Less than 1 hour of daylight. Somewhere to light a fire, so let's go have a look in this larger cabin. Because we're not going to make it back now to the big cabin. Cold pork and beans. Right, I'm starting to get a little bit hungry, a little bit thirsty, but we can hold out a bit more. Tinder plug. Okay. Matches. Newsprint. I feel like I had a really good roll getting that rifle immediately upon starting, and I don't deserve it because I'm such a beginner. Alright. Less than 1 hour of daylight left. We don't have enough time. We can make it back to that other cabin. There was no stove in here, which was what I was looking for. That was creepy. Salty crackers make us thirsty, so don't want to be eating them straight away. Throw off much heat because they're fake fire logs. Okay. Pork and beans. Bench, bed. Alright. We have nowhere else to go, so I think we're camping out here for the night. We'll rest for a few hours. Might have to wake up. We'll sleep for 8 hours, and hopefully not too hungry and thirsty by the time we wake up. Alright, we're really thirsty. I'm glad it auto woke me up, because otherwise I would have just died in my sleep. Alright, so we'll drink this soda that has the least. About to expire, basically. Quality. What else? Are we okay? A bit hungry, a bit thirsty. Alright. If we eat some crackers, that'll make us more thirsty. And then I can justify having another drink. And we've actually got some drinking water. Herbal tea. That's right, I'll drink a soda. And we should be able to go back to sleep for 3 hours of darkness. Alright. 13 hours of daylight. So I searched all these cabins. There was a cabin around the side of this lake here. Let's go have a look in that. I'm glad I went to the other one. I thought this one was broken down. Would have got caught out in the middle of the night in a broken down cabin. Look at these ones first. If we can. Nothing to look at, apparently. Alright, we'll just check out this one. Thirsty again. I'll drink a soda. And our bag's almost full as well. Alright, matches. Not a lot in this place. Hello, little fella, what you got for me? Ooh, a thin wool sweater. And some scrap metal. Let's have a look at our sweater. Alright, that's worse than everything I've got, basically. Or what I'm currently wearing. Alright, so we've had a look at all the ones around. We did those two. Let's make a beeline straight for that one. Oh, minus 23, we better hurry. That's a cold day in Canada. I was reading that there's this guy who has a 30-hour real-life streak for surviving in the long dark. I applaud that man. This is a really hard game. For me, anyway. So basically, he streamed it for 30 hours. And didn't die once. And that's a good effort. Rifle ammunition. Nice. How many? 5. Alright. We really want to save our rounds. So, if we can. Fire. If we can help it, we won't fire. We haven't checked out this cabin yet. So let's go there and let's hurry because it's really cold. I don't think you're meant to sprint everywhere because you get really tired. But you'd think it would help with the warmth. Especially when you're wearing coats and wool jumpers and all that. Some pork and beans. Empty plastic container. Not a whole lot in here either. 2 degrees, we're pretty cold. Pretty thirsty. Get some cloth and repair our wool jumper. Where?
Thursday.
There. What? I thought I got some cloth. Did I not get cloth from breaking down that thing? Oh. There it is. vest is way better. Let's see if I repair this, if it gets any better stats. Both the same, so we'll just use one. Okay, seems to have worked. There we go, nice. Now it's got its stats back up. We do need to repair our boots as well, I think. Cured leather. No idea where I can find that. I can probably find better jeans to wear, so we won't bother with that. I wish you could light a fire pretty much anywhere. That would be really handy. We don't know how many hours of daylight left. We're dehydrated. I don't think I have anything to drink except for my water. Start a fire anyway. Excellent.
What have we here?
Must be a snowstorm outside. Let's have a quick look. Sit on either since we broke it down. I guess I'm supposed to sleep. Alright, let's sleep for a couple of hours. We'll rest for 3 hours and see how we go. Alright. Good. Blizzard's over. We can head out. -5, that's not too bad. It's not -23 like it was the first day. Let's head to this fishing cabin. Some more cedar wood, newsprint, beef jerky, give me that, and orange soda. This orange soda is our actual last bit of water. And we're encumbered as well, flare shell, cool. Scrap metal, alright, so now we can't sprint, is that how this works? Or we just get tired more? We need to melt some snow so we can get some water, I think. So if we head back to that first cabin with the big stovepipe before the lake started, I think we'll make our camp there to start off with. It's such a pretty looking game. I wish I was better at it. Is that a wolf? The aiming is so sensitive. We actually do need to go that way though. Hopefully this wolf doesn't want to fight. We might be able to scare it off with the lantern though. What's that? There's another one. I think so. Alright, if we can get to the hut without it seeing us, it should leave us alone for a while. But honestly, it's pretty okay. We've got a lot of food. Biggest thing I'm missing is water and purification tablets. Hasn't noticed us yet, we might be able to get there safely. If we just creep past. No, this one's seen us. Back off, Wolfie. Didn't want to do that. Let's have a look at his friend. Alright, it's running away. Well, may as well harvest. Give me all the meat. Grab some hide, and we'll grab the gut. See if we can make us a nice bow.
Damn. Freezing.
Okay, pretty cold. Don't have time to go for the. Okay, really cold. We have to get to the cabin.
Too much stuff to carry.
Yeah, no. We're encumbered. We can get there though. It'll take me just as much time running with all this stuff in my backpack as it would to drop all the useless newspapers and stuff out. Come on, we can get there. Nearly there, keep going. Alright, just up a hill. We're gonna be fine. Glad that other wolf didn't come back. I didn't like shooting that first wolf, but he noticed me. And he was coming straight for me, all saw it. I was trying to intimidate it. I don't think I have any flares to scare it off with. I had no other choice. Alright, let's get inside. See if it can warm up a bit. The stove. Here we go. Alright, let's light this baby up. We definitely need some more accelerant. I suppose we've got. Let's see if we can get lucky with the. With no accelerant. Listen to that crackling fire. Gotta blow on it to keep the flames burning. Oh, it failed. Alright, let's just whack some accelerant on there. Some herbal tea. Oh, don't have any potable water. Alright, we definitely need to melt some snow. So we'll chuck some more. There we go, chuck some more wood on, melt some snow. Let's grab about 4 liters.
I could eat anything.
Alright, hungry, come on. Alright. Now, first of all, I'll eat something. Me cooked meat. Delicious. It's probably not that good, to be honest. Alright, still hungry. And still thirsty. Alright, we'll have a soda for now. while we cook up your supplies. We can purify our water. Let's cook some more food though, I reckon. Boil that water. I'm not sure if boiling and purifying do the same thing or not. Gonna have to collect some more reclaimed wood as well. Let's see what boiling this water does. Hopefully it purifies it. So we can purify with our tablets, we just have to boil it. That's good to know. Now we definitely want to cook some more meat. We'll cook up all that meat, I think, while we're going. Parched, drink some water, fresh water. Excellent, drain 0.61 litres, alright. So, if we're down about here, it's about 6 litres. Gotta remember that. So we know how much we need to drink for a full bar, pretty much. Tired, alright. Oh, he's got this fire here. Just melt some more snow. Chuck all the reclaimed wood on it. Probably just 2 litres this time, because we need to purify it as well. We'll save our purification tablets for when we really need them. Boil water. Cook some wolf meat. And then there's a bed in here, I think, so we can head to bed as well. I didn't notice that. That's silly. We'll drop this one here. And we'll head to bed. Should be good for... Let's rest for 10 hours. So that the day has a chance to start warming up. Another day in the wilderness. Alright, let's drink. Where's our water gone?
I need some water.
I know, I'm looking for it. There we go, drink. Alright, so for a very full bar, we drink 0.67 litres. Okay, maybe that changes from time to time. And let's eat some wolf meat. Take that. Let's put some stuff in this cupboard. Like this bedroll. How do I put that over there? Not like that. Excellent. We'll save some antiseptic. We'll save these socks and this sweater. Some pork and beans in there that need to be cooked anyway. And the coffee, don't need to carry that around with us. Sardines you might keep here as well, and the tea, don't need those with us. Alright. I do have a flare. I could have scared that thing off. Poor wolf. What's weighing me down here? Scrap metal, probably don't need that. Yet. Not sure what the crow feather does either. Organized by weight. There we go. That's lovely. Everything organized by weight. Other way. Okay. We kind of need most of this stuff. It's the only problem. The wolf pelt we don't need. Probably not the gut either. Or the feather. It's not very heavy. Flare shell, don't need that yet because we can't fire it. Whetstone, probably stay here. And that should be okay. I'll head back downstairs. And now we're ready to face the next day of our survival. But that might have to wait for another day. I'd like to thank you for joining me for this episode of The Long Dark. If you enjoyed it, feel free to leave your comments and let me know that you'd like this series to continue.